The structure moving across this field is designed to simulate drought conditions on these test crops located at the University of Missouri's Bradford Research and Extension Center.
Drought is the most important yield limiting factor around the world, and it's a problem many places.
The drought simulators are essentially mobile greenhouses measuring 50 by 100 feet. The two simulators are mounted on railroad tracks so they can be positioned to cover commercially important crops like corn and soybeans during rainy weather, then moved away to expose the plants during dry, sunny conditions.
With this facility, we can control when the plants experience water stress.
Researchers at MU's College of Agriculture, Food, and Natural Resources study the results of these controlled conditions to help develop crops more tolerant of water shortages.
We're not going to be able to make agricultural crop plants grow in a desert environment. What we're trying to do is understand how we can improve crop performance under conditions of limited water.
Robert Sharp focuses his research on the root systems of plants and their importance to a plant's growth and its ability to weather dry conditions.
The root systems are very important. They've been very much understudied, and because they're very difficult to study, you've got to be able to get those roots through the dry soil down into the moist soil. And if we can do that, we can substantially improve plant performance.
MU researchers say the drought simulators allow for in-depth testing under real-world conditions.
So in the field, plants are subject to this whole range of environmental stresses, and it's necessary to move from the lab to the field to begin to address that complexity.
This research is vital due to the devastating effects of drought and the ever-growing competition for fresh water.
From the University of Missouri, I'm Kent Faddis reporting.